I'm starting the day really slow. Today's goal is simple: learn Python in a day or less. This might seem like an impossible goal, but I have a plan that I think might just work. While some programming languages can introduce complex patterns and syntax that are hard to grasp, Python stands out for its simplicity, readability, and beginner-friendly design. I strongly believe I can get the hang of it, even though I haven't written any Python before. I'm also relying on my 6 to 7 years of production JavaScript experience, so I'm not exactly starting from scratch. Here's how I plan to go about this. First, I'll take a Python crash course, just enough to understand the syntax and how the language works.
Now I'm gonna actually count from there. I'm learning stuff without goal, you might imagine.
The key difference between learning your first programming language versus subsequent ones lies in how your brain processes the information. With your first language, you're building foundational knowledge, learning core concepts like variables, loops, and functions from scratch. But when you tackle your second, third, or fourth programming language, you're primarily matching patterns you already know to new syntax. It's just like learning a new dialect rather than an entirely new way of thinking, since the fundamental programming concepts remain consistent across most languages. This is why experienced developers can pick up new languages relatively quickly, and I think I'm quite experienced. Next, I'll dive into a real-world open source Python library to study its code. This hands-on approach will show me language constructs in action and help me learn concepts based on their relevance in modern Python. I've chosen TinyDB, a small key-value store written purely in Python. My goal is to understand the architecture of this library and what's happening under the hood. But here's the best part. I've got a secret weapon. Modern coding assistants make complex code feel approachable. It's like having a brilliant senior developer looking over your shoulder. I'll use Cursor to spot patterns to explain any confusing parts and break down complex concepts into bite-sized pieces. It's like having a 24/7 mentor ready along the way, and that changes everything. While I'm at it, I'll share some of my learnings and the most interesting differences I've noticed coming from a JavaScript background. The first concept that I thought was really interesting and novel from a JavaScript background was Python's Doctest feature.
The way a Doctest knows that you've got a test is you have the three-arrow prompt, and then an expression as input, and then the following lines are the output.
It's a way to embed tests directly in documentation strings. Unlike JavaScript, where we typically separate our tests into different files, Python allows you to write examples in your documentation that double as actual test cases. This approach not only ensures your documentation stays up to date with your code, but also serves as a built-in testing mechanism, something we don't have in JavaScript's JS doc system, for example. You can then run these tests with the doctest library via the command line or a test framework like PyTest. The second major shift was adapting to Python's classical object-oriented approach. Python has powerful features that embrace traditional OOP concepts. One fascinating example are donda methods. They're special methods that start and end with double underscores like init or string. These methods let you customize how your objects behave in various situations. For instance, defining how an object should be converted to a string, how it responds to mathematical operations, or what happens when you compare it to other objects. Think of donda methods as hooks that let you customize your object's behavior when Python's built-in operations are used on them. One of the most interesting tools I discovered was Poetry.
For two environments, where code's running, but also publish your code, your packages to Python. So today I'll walk you through the basics of Poetry.
Python's modern dependency management tool, similar to how npm yarn or pnpm works in the JavaScript ecosystem. It uses a pyproject.toml file, which is similar to package.json in JavaScript, and a poetry.log file, which is also similar to package.log.json. to ensure deterministic installations across different environments. What makes Poetry particularly powerful is its built-in virtual environment management. While JavaScript package managers focus primarily on dependency management, Poetry goes further by automatically creating isolated environments for your projects, handling package publishing, and managing build configurations. Think of it as combining NPM's package management with NVM's version management in a single tool. There's a lot more to cover, but I don't want to make this video very long. I'll mention some concepts that I'm excited to explore further in my Python journey. The first of them is type hints and annotations. These are handled by Python's typing module. I still don't get why we have a separate module for handling type hints, but this is something I plan to learn more about. Second of them is decorators. These are quite easy to understand because I already use them in JavaScript, but I'd love to know how Python's implementation differs. Another topic is exception handling, which is basically a way to handle errors in Python. Then there's magic and special methods in Python. I already learned about under methods, but I also love to learn more. Then I would love to learn about the module system, how modules are packaged and distributed, and probably even build mine. I'll also spend some time to learn about function arguments and parameters. We've come to the end of this vlog, and I can say I definitely learned a lot. I'm now at the point where I can at least read Python code without feeling like a total noob. That's a win in my opinion. Coming from JavaScript, Python feels like home in a lot of ways. Same basic concepts, just different ways of doing things. And honestly, having Cosmo by my side made the whole process way less intimidating. The next step for me is to try to build an actual application in Python. Or generally speaking, write more Python code. I have a bunch of videos lined up where I'll try to do this, and I'd love to invite you to subscribe to this YouTube channel. Now that's the end of this video. Thanks for hanging out with me, and catch you in the next one.